Today I'm going to show you guys what I consider to be the absolute best metal roof flashing detail for flashing standing seam roofs around curbs, chimneys, HVAC units, or skylights. Stick around and we'll show you how it's done. All right, so behind me, guys, I've got a mock-up of the 138T standing seam, and we've got a box built to represent a chimney, a curb, a skylight, or an HVAC unit on a residential or light commercial building. So what I want to show you is how we flash using the 138T. This detail is called the traverse panel detail. So if you can look behind the box, we built the box short so that you can see behind it. You can see some metal roofing running sideways or horizontal to the regular roof, and that's called the traverse panel detail. And I'm gonna take you around and show you kind of the ins and outs of it, and then we'll disassemble the system and we'll kind of show you how the flashing is done. All right, so we're gonna look at this box or this chimney or this curb HVAC unit from the front. And from the front, it's a fairly standard flashing detail like you'd find in most standing seam metal. We've got the front piece, we've got our sidewall overlapped, we're hooked into some Z here. And it's pretty standard, most profiles will do this. But as we come up the side and you get an idea of what we did on the sidewall, and then we turn the corner going to the back, you're gonna see something different that other standing seam metals don't do. So when we make it to this piece here, now we're into our traverse panel. So this is the key panel to this. And basically all this is a piece of 138T, and we've cut the leg off one side and we've fabricated a piece of 138T to fit behind whatever that this is, whatever this rooftop obstacle is, and it comes down and it's a solid piece of metal. It wraps around this and it gets folded to the piece of the sidewall. And this is really the key panel of this system, of the traverse panels. And then from there on, all we're doing is taking pieces of 138T and we're stepping them in sideways all the way up until we get to the hip cap, the ridge cap, the high side flashing, whatever it is. And then we're gonna cut the leg off the top panel, slide it right up underneath the ridge. And this is now a watertight system. And if you notice, water now, it won't run down and head right into the back of an obstacle just like this. The water's gonna stop, it's gonna run out off to the side, so we don't even have the same amount of water that hits behind a chimney. So that's why this flashing detail works. This is an amazingly simple way to flash in rooftop obstacles. It works every single time. It doesn't matter the width. You don't need a curb. It solves the problem. It's flexible because these are the roof panels, and this is a very easy thing to do. So we're going to take some of these panels off and we'll show you what we've done and how we've got to this point. So if you're watching this video at home and you're wondering, well, why do we even need to talk about this detail? What does it matter? All I care about is that my metal roof looks good from the road and that makes my house or my building look great. This is why it matters. I want to show you what happens on a metal roof when you hit a rooftop obstacle like a curb, chimney, skylight, HVAC, something like a box. And I built this box on purpose. I made it wider than the width of the panel. So we got a 16-inch 138T panel, and I made this box to take up a full panel and then a half of the next one so that you could see how important that the flashing behind these rooftop obstacles is. So if you can imagine it's raining, where does the water go? So this is the panel, this is the panel, this is the panel. If water's running down here, like where is it supposed to go? This is not just a problem for standing seam. This is a problem that metal roofing has in general, whether it's a screw down metal or an R panel or a standing seam or a double, whatever it is. You've got to do something with the water. You can't just head water into a box, and that's what the traverse panel solves. So we go ahead and we roof the 138T in like this, and then what we do is we do the front of our flashings just like we showed you earlier. So we're down here, we're gonna do the front, the thing. And what the thing that we do different to start this traverse panel is we're gonna fill in these voids with 1.5 polyiso, which I'm gonna do here in just a second. And what I've got here, I've got the Z channel that runs from my sidewall flashing of my assembly. Instead of stopping it back here and trying to do some kind of offset cleat back behind the chimney or making up some kind of a piece of an apron flashing in the back. We're going to let our Z run all the way up to the ridge, and we're going to fill this void in with polyiso, and you'll see it here in just a second. All right, guys, so what we've done is we've taken some 1.5-inch rigid roof insulation, some polyiso, the same kind that you would use for like a flat roof install. It's what we use for our on our flat roofing projects. And so we've just cut it down to fit inside the metal pan. So in between the 138T, we dropped in the rigid. And the reason why we do this is because when we start to lay these traverse panels, we're gonna be standing on these, and we want something rigid there so that the panel doesn't kink, and we can stand in here and work without damaging the panel. The next thing I wanna show you is on the Z, we showed you how the Z, instead of stopping it here and trying to offset cleat and come into it, we let our Z run all the way up to the ridge. And so I've got some tape sealer, or you might call it butyl, got some butyl on here, and that's what we're gonna start our first traverse panel. And that's how, what I'm gonna show you next is how we get the first traverse panel to bend, come up the wall, and then grab onto the side of our side wall here. All right, so here we've got just a regular piece of 138T, and I wanna show you how we get from this to that. And this is our first piece behind the chimney, but basically, the reason why this traverse panel detail is so awesome is because we don't have anything special. We just use panels right off the roof to make this detail. So here's what it looks like. Here's what the roofing panel looks like. And we take this, and we cut the back leg off the panel, and we start to fold and fabricate. So for the traverse panel, we're gonna just turn down the sides, and I've got this side turned down as well. This part here is gonna go up against the chimney, so it's bent to the angle. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna run it out to where our sidewall stops, and then we're gonna grab onto the top of our sidewall with this hook right here. So I'll set this in place, take a look at this piece, but I'll set this in place and you'll see how it looks when we've got it installed. All right, so we're gonna set this first traverse panel. And remember, it was just a regular piece of 138T, and all we did was field fabricate it with some hand snips and some hand tongs. So we would pull our butyl back, this tape sealer, pull it back. I'm not gonna do it for the sake of this. And then we're just gonna set it down onto our Z on that side, and I'm gonna put my panel into place, and remember my little hook here, I'm gonna lay that on top of my sidewall, so I've got a watertight joint between these two. And then basically what I'm doing now is I'm ready, set up with my 138T, my neutral leg, I'm ready to drop in the rest of my panels. It is that simple to drop this in, and then I'm gonna take my seam cap, and we'll show you that in a second. So let me drop in a few more of these traverse panels, and then we'll put the seam caps on, and we'll get back to how the traverse panel's done. All right, so I just dropped in a couple more panels. It's a very simple fold down. And then the thing that I wanted to show you in this one was butyl tape goes on the Z, which is we showed you there, and then butyl tape will go in between these two panels. And then what we do on this one is we leave a little hook. I've got the hook on this panel, and this panel. So on the high side, we'll have butyl in between the panels, and then we'll take that little hook and we'll just fold it around. So water coming out of here hits this and just drops off. So I'll take my hooks and I'll fold these around just like that. And now we're ready for the seam cap to be dropped onto each one of these pieces. All right, so we've got all of these traverse panels. We got our first one we showed you, and then all we did was lay in other panels, and we ran up, and then when we got to the ridge, all we did was just basically cut the leg of the panel off and slide it up under the ridge, and then in an install, we would either turn a hem on it, we would run caulk, rivet that back down, so make a tight joint on the ridge, and then basically that's the traverse panel detail. The one thing I would say, if you get this detail and see, or in some of our other videos, you'll see screws in this part of the panel right here in the traverse detail. So when you think standing seam, you think no screws, no exposed fasteners. Here we will have exposed fasteners, but I wanted to just briefly touch on them. They're gonna be a cap screw, a long life, we call them Zacks, and they're gonna hit in the front of this panel here, but they're gonna go to the outside edge of the Z. So even if those panels, or even if those screws fail, water doesn't leak inside the system or the inside the panels that are behind the curb. Right here is the Z and the leg of the Z here. So even if that screw fails, it's running through butyl, and then the water would drip out into this panel and run on off to the roof. So you'll see screws from us here, and that's how we hold the traverse panel detail on. But that's a fantastic way to flash in any kind of rooftop obstacle.